Anna, I genuinely had to look at my clock, my watch, to find out what day it was. It's been that kind of festival and I've only been here 48 hours. How's it been for you?
Amazing.
Yeah?
I went to the mountains and super hot, but yeah. It's been amazing, yes.
Okay, so let's just clear this up. Did you, like me, pack far too many things?
Yes. Yes. But
there's an art to packing for Tomorrowland Winter and I've not yet got it right. So tell me, what did you pack? What were your expectations?
Well, I brought like super heavy shoes for snow and 3 heavy coats.
Yep.
And then I'm sweating here in the...
It's warm, isn't it, on
yes,
the mountains?
It's super warm.
So I did the same. I paid extra luggage to get all the big bag through. And I've got big feet, so one pair of shoes takes up one sort of suitcase. I got the warm coat, not touched it. I've got the jumpers, not touched it. It's very much T-shirt weather. Now, it's Wednesday. That meant you're playing at the Cage tonight. How, you've obviously seen and tasted and been around the festival. Is that getting you excited for your set later on today?
I actually didn't go to the stage. I went to the mountains, the other stages, and everyone's super happy to be here with the flags and having a good time. I think we are gonna have a good night at the Cage today.
It's vibey, isn't it? There's a real nice atmosphere in the air. Yeah, everyone's happy to be here. Like you could walk around and see people that you may know. Likewise,
a lot of Brazilians.
Amazing.
I have to say.
Now, honestly, you see Brazilian flags, you see like the smoke, the smoke things that they look, yellow and green ones everywhere. So like the mountains are green and yellow. It's a beautiful sight. Let's go back to Brazil right now, because you're from a musical family, right?
Yeah, actually my father was a DJ and had a club in our small countryside city. But yeah, it's just my brother also DJ. Yeah, actually
a musical family.
Yes.
It's easy to see where you got your influences from, right? So what, the musical influences from your dad. Tell me like a couple of the kind of style he would have played back when he was DJ.
Yeah, my father used to play everything. He was a DJ, but he only played at the club that he owned with my uncle.
Yeah.
So he used to play everything from like Todd Terry to Corona to like DJ Bobo to everything.
Which is come full circle, because that stuff's getting played right now, isn't it? It's all over the place. So you used to hang out at your father's club. You were influenced by music around you. And then that leads you to where you are now with, Beatport Breakthrough Awards. Busy touring schedules. And let's talk about Intentions, the album, So congratulations, first and foremost.
Thank you.
You dropped a track last week. Talk to us about the album, the concepts, the tracks. Come on, where do we start?
Well, this is my first album. I've released a lot of EPs and singles for underground techno music. That is what I'm known for. And this is my first album. It is not techno. It is an album of ambient music mixed with meditation and sound healing modalities. Because I was using this music for my own journey, for my own discovery, my inner discovery, and the opportunity to share this with people happened. And then suddenly we have an album, and I have John Hopkins and Max Cooper and Laraji collaborating. We signed the album in Universal, so it became out of nothing, this project became big. And it is called Intentions because each track has a specific intention encoded into it. Because I was using, like I said, I was using for my own journey. Mm-hmm. So tracks to connect, to open up, to surrender, to go deeper into yourself.
And then
this is now available for everyone, and we are creating an immersive website that you can go there and put your own intentions and merge with the visuals, with the text, and with the frequencies, and see how you receive all of this.
So, am I right in saying, is it true that you get up at 5 a.m. every day?
Yes, sometimes before, I love to wake up early, and I meditate 1.5 hours and 1 hour, and then I do coach hour, and then I'm ready for the day.
See, I'm super impressed by it. But what it boils down to, from the outside looking in, is you are super disciplined. You have to be, right?
I am. It's not every day, of course, because I tour a lot and I have a lot of time zones. But like when I am in my house and I have my routine, I like to wake up before the sun so I can watch the sun.
Beautiful.
The sun, I love. I think I'm getting old.
I'll be honest. I don't imagine you'll be up at 5 a.m. tomorrow. I think you'll probably be more going to bed at 5 a.m.
Yes, yes, yes. Right. Today I woke up at 3 a.m. to come to Tomorrowland. But okay.
So some meditation on the plane and all that.
But I hated to wake up early. Like some years ago, I think something just changed.
But so, for example, in a normal day, in a normal world, in a normal place, Have you been listening to Intentions at 5 a.m. and then?
No, I don't listen to. It's not always that I work with sound, uh-huh. but normally what I do, I wake up super early, I take a cold shower or a cold plunge, mm-hmm. and then I meditate. Usually I don't meditate with music. But it happens I'm listening a lot of Intentions right now because we are in the middle of the campaign.
Yeah.
So I'm listening to it a lot and getting the mood. We are shooting documentary, creating website, and we are promoting also. So I'm in the Intentions mood.
The cold therapy thing is taking off around the world. Like, I mean,
I love it.
You're doing it. I saw Lost Frequencies doing a cold plunge the other day. Steve Aoki's a huge fan. He's actually got a cold, an ice bath in his garden, in his Vegas house. So why should people do it?
Because you feel so good after, it helps you with your nervous system, with your dopamine levels. And if you can be there 3 minutes, I like to do 6 degrees.
Yeah.
6 to 10 degrees is my sweet spot. And you feel super good. You feel more energetic, clear mind. There are a lot of scientific stuff that you can look in the internet, but you feel super good after.
It's funny because your album's called Intentions. It wasn't my intention to do a cold therapy plunge at my hotel pool. But turns out they don't heat it, and it was freezing, so I did it today.
Accidentally. I'm going to go there.
Accidentally. Look, it's fascinating. Congratulations. I really love the concept. I love the depth. I love the thought. I love the humanness of it all, you know, the reality of it all.
Thank you.
So that's the serious stuff. I want to have some fun now, because we are in the mountains, and that's what happens. We've asked the people of Tomorrow from around the world to just send some of the questions in. So we've got a jar in front of us. I want you to just dig your hand in, pick one question. I genuinely can't tell you what the kind of questions are, so throw your hands in, choose a question, and then let's find out the answer from Anna. Come on, what's it say?
When was the last time you cried?
Oh, there you go.
Oh my God, I'm going to be a little bit deep, but I think it was yesterday, looking at the sky. I got a moment, like with everything that was happening, and I cried, but I cried of happiness and gratefulness, not of sadness.
No, okay, that's good. So tears of joy.
I'm being a little bit cheesy today.
No. You're allowed. That's totally allowed. One more. Come on, one more. Let's see where this goes. These are not, you know my kind of questions. These are people of tomorrow's questions. So,
if you could woke up tomorrow, have gained any one quality or ability, what would it be? Teletransport.
Is that because
sure.
you don't have to get up so early to catch the plane?
No, because we spend so much time in airports and in the plane. I just wanted to be there right now. I want to be in top of the mountain right now. Let's do it.
It's good. Like that. And I would love that. It's very much like a Harry Potter thing, you know, all of that.
That's it.
So you're playing at the Cage tonight. You are going to be at the Core tomorrow. That's going to be insane.
Is it nice? I didn't go there today.
I'm not going to ruin it for you, but the answer is yes. And I believe that there is something going on with Leigh Ballouk as well.
Tomorrow we have a very early podcast.
Yes. Uh-huh.
I think it's 9 a.m.
So be prepared. It's an open cable car. You're going to have a chat just going to the top of the mountain, so it's going to last about 8 minutes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And Luke's going to hold this. I've done it before. Luke's going to ask you all these questions, so just be prepared. So that's tomorrow. Back to here and now. I want to ask you, we've got a clock, it's 23 seconds long, and I'm going to ask you the most stupidest questions, and we've got a leaderboard. I really want you to be at the top of it, all right?
Okay.
So you've got to beat Leigh Ballouk, and tomorrow you can have bragging rights with Leigh Ballouk, all right?
Okay.
So the 23 seconds, because it's Tomorrowland 2023, I just want the answer that comes to your head. And Danny, can we? I need someone to just check Anna's answers, please, on the quiz. All right, listen carefully. Here we go. The clock.
Oh my God.
You can't hear the clock. We can hear the clock. Okay, clock starting, and let's go with this. What color is a typical winter hat?
Brown.
What do you wear on your feet to keep warm?
Socks.
What is the opposite of sunburn?
I don't know.
What is the color of a typical winter scarf?
Red.
What is the opposite of slow?
Fast.
What do you clean your teeth with?
Toothpaste.
And what is the colour of the sun? Last one.
What?
What is the colour of the sun?
Yellow.
Okay, good. So, Danny, how many did we get?
Five.
I don't believe it. Luke beat
you. Is it good?
Well, Luke got 8.
Oh my God, so, that's so slow.
Yeah, you got five, and don't worry about
don't
it.
Don't compare yourself.
No, exactly. And especially not to lay back Luke. Throw a snowball at him tomorrow and it'll be even.
Okay.
Anna, it's been a pleasure to have you
Thank
here.
Thank you so much.
Very excited about your journey in the future with this album as well. I'm looking forward to remixes because obviously that's what's going to happen somewhere down the line. We'll talk more about that later. Anna, have a great time. Tomorrowland Winter awaits. Enjoy the cage, enjoy core. Right now we're going back to the main stage here at Tomorrowland Winter.
Thank you.